Hello students, in this part we are going to see the numericals which is based on the formula. Here you can see that I have written a formula in the terms of work done, okay. Another formula I have written in the terms of potential difference, okay. And the another formula, Ohm's law. And the another one which I have, that is the Ohm's law formula only we have, but that we are going to see. And we are going to see that how we can utilize these formulas in the numerical. So we are going to, in the previous class we have discussed about the current and its cause, and we have seen the properties of charge, what is electric charge, electricity, electric circuit, voltage, Ohm's law, resistance, and factors on which the resistance depends. We are going to jump to the questions now. Here in the given problem you can see they have given, calculate the amount of work done to carry a 4 coulomb of charge from a point at 100 volt to 200 volt. They have given us in the given problem, if we are going to see here what is given, they have given to us in this given question number 1. Here they have given what? They have given us, if you will see, that we have to carry a point or we have to carry a charge, okay? That is, they have given a value of charge, that is of 4 coulomb, and that charge we have to carry from 100 volt to a point of 220 volt. In this, if you will see, they have given us 2 volts. It means they are talking about potential difference. You remember what is the formula for potential difference? Work done karte the, hai na? Difference ki baat hum jab bhi karte, that means the 2 potential difference. Here you can see, always remember where we have reached 120. It means how I will find here. They are simply, you can understand this problem like this, okay. Suppose I have point A and I have point B. I have reached to point B, this is my 120 volt, and I have started with 100 volt. And kitna coulomb charge leke I have to move is, that is 4 coulomb of charge I have to take and I have to go. So what the question says, to calculate the amount work done to carry a 4 coulomb of charge, this 4 coulomb of charge we have to take from 100 volt to 120 volt. Always remember the formula, what it is, that how we are going to find where we have reached, where we have reached minus from where we have come. Always remember. So where we have reached to 120 minus where from where we have come from 100 volts. So how much it will be? It will be 20 volts. So we got that potential difference VAB, that is 20 volt. This is clear to you. Now what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the amount of work done. It means we have to calculate the W. So what is the formula for amount of work done? You can remember from W upon Q. This is the formula. We have V, we have Q, we have to find out W. So what is work done? Work done is equals to what, beta? Potential into charge. What is potential? That is 20. What is the value of charge they have given? That is 4. So 4 into 2. So what you will get? You will get 80 joules. So this is the unit for work done, that is joules. So 80 joule work is required to bring this 4 coulomb of charge from point A to point B. This is clear. Now we are going to see the second problem. Okay. Problem 2. What is the resistance of an electric arc lamp when hot? If the lamp uses, here they have given us what? If the lamp uses 20 ampere, always remember the unit will tells you that what is given. 20 ampere means they are talking about current, okay? When connected to a 220 volt, they have given us 220 volt potential difference they have given, and they have asked us to calculate the resistance. So from the Ohm's law we have the formula. What is that formula? Says R is equals to V upon I. You remember from where I have written V is equals to IR we got, no? So R formula I need to find it out. So I will find it out from here. What is V? That is 220, and what is I? That is 20. So you can cancel it out. So you will find it that resistance is, resistance so unit is what? Yes, it is ohm. So resistance is, how much resistance is required? That is 11 ohm resistance which is required for this. Okay, now we are going to see the third problem. What is the third problem says? Here the third problem says, calculate the potential difference required, we have to calculate what potential difference required across a conductor of resistance. They have given us the resistance of 5 ohm to make a current, and they have given us the current that is 1.5 amperes flow through it. Okay, so we have the value of current, we have the value of resistance. So which formula we are going to use? Obviously we are going to use a Ohm's law formula. What it says, V is equals to IR. We need to find out V. So V, how we can find out? I is given 1.5, and what is the value of your resistance is 5. So multiply these two. When you will multiply, what you will get? You will get 7.5 volt. So this is the answer for your potential difference. Okay. Now we are going to see the fourth problem related to this. Here the fourth problem says, a torch bulb when cold has 1 ohm resistance. Understand, suppose we have a torch, okay, and in this torch we have a bulb, okay. When it is cold, it has a resistance of 1 ohm, okay. It means they have given a resistance of 1 ohm when the torch bulb is cold, okay. It draws a current of 0.5 ampere. How much current it draws? 0.3 ampere current when glowing from the source. Kab le raha hai jab wo glow kar raha hai. It means when it is used, or hum bolte jab wo jal raha hai, right? And what is the EMF of that, or the potential is what? That is 3 volt. Calculate the resistance of the bulb when glowing and explain the reason for the difference in the resistance. Understand. क्वेश्चन समझना है आपको. दे हैव गिवन अस द रेजिस्टेंस. कब रेजिस्टेंस दिया है? जब आपका बल्ब बंद है. यू हैव नोटिस्ड वन थिंग, व्हेन द बल्ब इज ग्लोइंग दैट टाइम यू हैव ऑब्जर्व दैट द बल्ब इज टेम्परेचर ऑफ द बल्ब इज बिकमिंग हॉट, राइट? व्हेन इट इज ऑफ दैट टाइम यू हैव नोटिस्ड दैट द बल्ब टेम्परेचर और द बल्ब व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू टच इट इज कोल्ड. सो व्हेन इट इज एट बिगिनिंग, और बिगिनिंग भी आप इनिशियली भी देखोगे तो इट विल बी कोल्ड, राइट? हाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट? वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द टेम्परेचर व्हेन द करंट फ्लोस थ्रू इट. सो हाउ आई विल स्टार्ट विथ? अगेन द फॉर्मूला फ्रॉम द ओम्स लॉ. व्हाट इट सेज, वी इज इक्वल्स टू आई आर. आई एम गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द रेजिस्टेंस. रेजिस्टेंस व्हेन द बल्ब इज ग्लोइंग, ओके. दिस इज द रेजिस्टेंस व्हेन योर बल्ब इज ग्लोइंग. When the bulb is glowing. When the bulb is glowing, the resistance will be what? V upon I. What is V? From there you can say 3. And what is here? This is 0.3. So we can write it down, this 3 into 10. So this will get cancelled out. We will have the 10 ohm resistance. It means that when the bulb is glowing, जब वो जलेगा तो obviously उसका resistance बढ़ेगा. हमने देखा था that resistance is directly proportional to the temperature. If the temperature is increasing, it means the resistance is increasing. See, the temperature is increasing, so the resistance too increasing. So the reason is also what? When the resistance of the filament of the bulb increases from 1 ohm to 10 ohm, so obviously it is just because of the property of the resistance, that is directly proportional to the temperature. When the temperature resistance increases, it means the temperature, or we can say when temperature is increasing, resistance too increases. Okay, now we are going to see the next problem. Okay, problem 5. How much current does an electric heater draws from? We have to find out how much current draws from an electric heater when the voltage is 220 volt in the line and the resistance they have given, that is 50 ohm. What we have to calculate? Obviously the current. Here you can understand what? That the formula of Ohm's law is very important, that you have to keep it in mind, because again we have to use this. V is equals to, we have IR, so we need to find out the current. So V upon R will gives me what? Current. So here I will substitute the value. I is equals to what? 220 volt, because potential value is 220 volt upon 50, right? This you can cancel it out. You will get this as current as is equals to 4.4 ampere. So this is the numerical which is based on work done. Okay. And the another one we have seen, that is based on Ohm's law. Okay. ओनली वन थिंग यू हैव टू कीप इट इन माइंड दैट इन वर्क डन जब भी आप पोटेंशियल निकालते हो पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस यू हैव टू ऑलवेज माइनस वेयर यू हैव रीच्ड माइनस फ्रॉम वेयर यू हैव कम. दिस इज द सिंपल रूल विच यू हैव टू फॉलो. ओके सो थैंक यू. नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ रिलेटेड टू रेसिस्टेंस और रेसिस्टिविटी. ओके थैंक यू.